Okay, hello everybody. Welcome to my first Python 3 tutorial. So first things first, we're gonna install the IDE. This is gonna allow you to actually write the Python programming language. Before we get into any Python or any, you know, terms and how to write Python, we have to install this so we can actually run our programs. So this is the link we're going to go to. We're going to be installing a IDE called Spider2. It's going to be off of a program called Anaconda, and it's a very good IDE, and I've been using it for a couple months now. It's very good. So what we're going to do is we're going to be going to this link, and depending on which, so we're going to click on Anaconda, sorry. Depending on which operating system you're using, Linux, Apple, or Windows, choose whichever one you'd want to do, but we are going to choose Windows because I have Windows, and we're going to do the Python 3.6 version. Now, the difference between the 2.7 and 3.6 is that the syntax is actually different for some objects in Python 2.7 and Python 3.6, so we're going to choose Python 3.6, and depending on which type of computer you have, 64-bit or 32-bit, you're going to install whichever one you have, and in order to find out what bit machine you have, you'll click start, you'll right click computer. If you have, you know, if you have a Windows 7, but this is Windows 10, so it's going to be a little different. I'm just going to find it out right now. I'm actually going to do computer, this PC. I'm going to right click that. Click properties. Now this is basically what you're gonna see. It says right here 64-bit operating system. That's whichever one you're gonna use. So if it says 32-bit, you're gonna do 32-bit installer, and if it says 64-bit, you're doing a 64-bit installer. Now this is just a really simple, really easy way to get an IDE really quickly. It's mostly all done for you. If you're using Chrome, you're gonna click keep. I'm pretty sure it's different with Internet Explorer, Microsoft Edge, Opera, whatever you use, Firefox, and now we're just gonna wait for it to download. So now that it's downloaded, what we're gonna do is we're gonna click on it, and usually it's gonna tell you to, you know, it'll say either run or do something. I already have it all set up right over here. So what we're going to do is we're going to click next, we're going to go through this installer, agree, do just me. If it really doesn't matter if you're on a shared computer, like a school computer or some place at a library, you will click just me. So after you've downloaded it and installed it, you'll see a screen like this. This is called the Anaconda Navigator. It's sort of like, you know, an app store for, I don't know, coding stuff. So you're going to want to launch this. I believe it will also let you launch a separate application. So through the Anaconda Navigator, we can launch Spider. But anyway, I'm going to show you what this looks like. So this is Spider 3. I've been saying Spider 2 the whole time, but it's Spider 3. It's a coding IDE. This is a program I wrote. It's currently broken at the moment, so it's not going to work. But this is basically what you can get up to doing through this video series if you follow along. This is a genetic algorithm, so it basically plays a snake game randomly, and then it changes stuff around until it can play a snake game perfectly. It doesn't work right now, so I'm not going to show you it.
Thank you for watching.
We will be doing a Hello World program in the next video. It's going to be pretty simple, so stay tuned for that, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Goodbye. So again, thank you for watching. It might be a little bit unbearable to watch these first videos because I'm just sort of learning how to do things, but the next couple of videos will have less ums and uhs in it. I already cut out enough from these videos, but you know, stay tuned. They'll get better. Forgive me. Goodbye.